Welcome to a quick review of the domain and range of 9 basic functions. We'll be reviewing the domain and range of the 9 functions listed here. Let's begin with a review of the definitions of domain and range. The domain is a set of all possible inputs of a function. Normally this would be the possible x values on the coordinate plane, or the values along the horizontal axis. And the range is a set of all possible outputs of a function. Normally this would be the possible y values on the coordinate plane, or the values along the vertical axis. So by analyzing the behavior of the graph along the x and y axis, or horizontal and vertical axis, we can determine the domain and the range of our functions. To begin, let's consider the constant function f of x equals c, or if we want y equals c. As an example, this is the graph of f of x equals 2. Notice for the domain, there's not even an x in the equation, and therefore x can be any real number. Or if we look at the behavior of the graph horizontally or along the x-axis, notice how if we projected this onto the x-axis, notice how the graph would go to the right forever and to the left forever with no breaks or holes, indicating the domain would be all real numbers. We're using interval notation from negative infinity to positive infinity, or using inequalities, we can say x is greater than negative infinity and less than positive infinity. But then for the range, notice how the y value must always equal the constant c, or in this case 2. Notice if we projected this graph onto the y-axis, the only y value would be positive 2. So for the range of the basic constant function, using interval notation, it would be the closed interval containing c, or we could say y must equal c for the range. Next, for the identity function, f of x equals x, or y equals x. Again, there's no restrictions on the possible values of x. We're looking at the line. Notice how it moves right forever and left forever with no breaks or holes. Or if we projected this onto the x-axis, again, it would go to the right forever and to the left forever with no breaks or holes, and therefore the domain would be all reals. Using interval notation or using inequalities. If the domain is all reals and y equals x, the range will also be all reals. Looking at the behavior of the graph, notice how it goes up forever and down forever with no breaks or holes. Or if we projected this onto the y-axis, it would go up forever and down forever with no breaks or holes. So the range and the domain are the same. But of course we have to use y here when using inequalities. Next we have the absolute value function, f of x equals the absolute value of x. Again, x can be any real number. Looking at the behavior of the graph, notice how projecting onto the x-axis, the graph would go right forever and left forever with no breaks or holes. Verifying all reals for the domain. Notice how the range of the y values would always be non-negative. Notice how the graph starts at a y value of 0 and goes up from there. Or projected onto the y-axis, it would start here and go up forever. So the range would be the interval from 0 to infinity, closed on 0, because it includes 0, or we can say y is greater than or equal to 0. Next, we have the quadratic function f of x equals x squared. Of course, the graph is going up very quickly, but it also goes left and right forever with no breaks or holes. So projecting onto the x-axis to help us find the domain, the graph would go right forever and left forever. So the domain is all reals. But the range of the y values are always non-negative. If we project this onto the y-axis, notice how the y values start at 0 and increase forever. So the range would be the closed interval from 0 to infinity. Next we have the cubic function f of x equals x cubed. Notice how the graph goes up and down very quickly, but it is also moving right and left forever. So projecting onto the x-axis, this graph would go to the right and left forever with no breaks or holes, and it also goes up and down forever with no breaks or holes. Therefore, both the domain and range would be all reals. Next, we have the square root function, f of x equals the square root of x, or y equals the square root of x. Notice here, x must be non-negative, otherwise we'd have an imaginary number. Or looking at the graph for the x values, notice how the graph starts at 0 on the x-axis and moves to the right forever. Notice how 0 is included because the square root of 0 is 0. So the domain would be the interval from 0 to infinity closed on 0, or we could say x is greater than or equal to 0. And the range or y values would also always be non-negative. Looking at the graph, projecting onto the y-axis, the graph would start at 0 on the y-axis and increase forever. So the range would also be from 0 to infinity closed on 0. Next, we have the cube root function, or f of x equals the cube root of x. Again, there are no restrictions on x as long as it's a real number. Projecting this onto the x-axis, notice how the graph moves to the right forever and to the left forever, so the domain would be all reals. And again, even though the graph is moving to the right and left very quickly, it does continue to move upward and downward forever. So projecting onto the y-axis, this graph would go up forever and down forever, again with no breaks or holes, so the domain would also be all reals. Next we have the reciprocal function. Notice how if x was 0, we'd have division by 0, which is undefined. Or looking at the graph, projecting onto the x-axis, we have a vertical asymptote here, so there's a break at x equals 0, but then from here the graph does move to the right forever and left forever. So the domain would be all reals excluding x equals 0. So using interval notation, we'd have from negative infinity to 0, open on 0, union from 0 to positive infinity, again open on 0. Using inequalities, we would say x is less than 0, or x is greater than 0. And then for the range, notice how the graph goes up forever and down forever, but again there is a break at y equals 0. So projecting onto the y-axis, we exclude y equals 0, and then increases forever and decreases forever. So the range is the same as the domain. Our last function is a reciprocal squared function, or f of x equals 1 divided by x squared. Considering the domain, notice how if x is 0, we have division by 0 again, which is undefined. So we must exclude 0. We're analyzing the graph. Notice how there's a break in the graph at x equals 0, but the graph does continue to move right forever and left forever. So our domain would be all reals except 0. And then for the range, notice how the y values would always be non-negative and also never 0. So if we project our graph onto the y-axis, you would exclude y equals 0, and then the y values would increase from there. So the range would be the interval from 0 to infinity, open on 0. Again, y can never be 0. We're using inequalities, we would say y is always greater than 0. I hope you found this review helpful.